We're going to be building this app in stages across 4 lessons in this course. And we'll come back to this course map periodically to track our progress. In lesson 1, we're going to learn about how to show multiple screens in your app. We're going to leave the other screens blank temporarily and dive into the fundamentals of how Android handles user touch events in your app. So in lesson 2, we're going to display a list of words in the app. We'll show the English and Miwok translations for each word. And this involves learning about arrays and lists, which are Java data structures to store data in our app. Then, in lesson 3, we're going to improve upon the lists so we can show images in the lists alongside each word. Once this functionality works, we're going to make visual changes, color, font style, spacing, so that the app looks more like the design mocks we were given. In lesson 4, we're going to add the play icon to each list item and learn about the media player in Android. So we had Andrew record record audio files on how to pronounce each Miwok word. So we'll play each MP3 file when the user clicks on a list item. And at this point, we have a fully functioning app. As we mentioned earlier, there are many ways to build this Miwok language app. So we want to show you another way you can modify the app to have a different navigation flow. In lesson 5, we'll integrate all 4 lists of vocabulary words into a single activity, made up of 4 different fragments that you can swipe through. There are also tabs across the top. And this is a common pattern in Android apps that we thought you might find useful. For example, the Google Play Store uses this design when allowing users to browse through apps. So while the focus of this course is on building a Miwok language app, the skills you learn here can easily be transferred to any other app. By the end of this course, you'll know how to create an app with multiple screens, display lists of data, play audio files, and you'll become more comfortable with Java-oriented programming concepts. These fundamentals will help you build more complex Android apps with even better user experiences.